In interesting solution news.
Oh, shit.
What happened?
Very
curious.
What
are you thinking?
I have no idea.
Yeah.
I literally have, like, my brain is blank because I don't know what interesting solution news.
Yeah. Well, after being married to him, anything is possible. Like, anything is possible. So
yeah, he picks up shit with his bare hands.
Like, literally?
Dog shit.
Literally, dog shit.
Wait, hold on. Is this like an inside joke, or do you really
No,
he
really does.
Because he thinks it's funny.
With no bag?
Well, not all the time.
Not all the time.
It's just when the piece of shit looks like a joke. And it's not his own shit, it's like dog shit.
I love how you're trying to make it make sense. I mean, no, listen. Okay, it's not all the time, first of all. Don't do that. And it's all, if it's only if it looks
funny. Well, because you're judging me for...
No, I'm not. It was all...
You just feel embarrassed because he does it.
That's what it
is. Are you judging her for marrying this man?
No, that's all
I'm very embarrassed that my husband... whom I willingly married and had a child with.
A man who picks up dog shit with his bare hands.
I only get for a reaction out of her, because I know I can get a reaction.
Is it only when it looks really solid?
Yeah. But it's nice and dry.
Here's the thing, if he was alone, he wouldn't do it.
Yeah.
Because his wife is there, he wants to do it.
So I'm normal now.
Yes.
I'm normal now, okay.
And that's an interesting solution.
Yes.
That's what I'm talking about.
To get a laugh, like, I'm not gonna tell a joke.
Interesting solution.
Grabbing poop. Yeah. This is submitted by Telemundo. An elementary school is currently experimenting with rough housing zones at recess.
Rehab? Like, oh, shit.
I was about to say rehab.
An elementary school has rehab.
Rough housing zone at recess.
That's funny.
Damn. So if, like, kids want to, like, wrestle and, like, or play dodgeball or something, go into this zone? Is that what they're doing?
I don't mind that. Because that's kind of what school was for us. Like, you knew that certain, like, you don't want to go in that pocket of the sandbox. Because those
crazy
are
over
the
there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But now I guess it's just organized.
Yeah, so.
Organized crazy?
Yeah.
This is in Canada.
They would have solutions like that.
Yeah, they would.
Bitch ass Canada.
At my elementary school, there wasn't really a zone. It was more the person.
Yeah, you got to stay away from
the
that
person,
kid.
Because
usually, like, the swings, it's like the most chillest. Everyone's in their own lane, you know?
Yeah.
But then sometimes they're that person that comes that likes grabbing the empty swing and throwing it at people.
Mm-hmm.
So it's usually the specific rough guy you want to stay away from.
The one that acts like Animal from the Muppets or whatever.
Anything can turn into a war zone when that guy comes around.
They have cracked down on any form of rough physical play at these particular schools. Like, they don't allow any of it.
Oh, you know what I thought they did? I thought they were cool, and I thought they were like, oh, okay, you guys are the ones that like to play rough. Here, you guys have this whole corner.
Okay, so now they're doing that.
Oh, good.
Yeah, yeah. Before there was zero tolerance
for anything. Before it was zero, and then now they're like, well, they're kids. They should have some sort of physical fun, and
good.
So we're gonna have these designated areas, and these kids are gonna go through a training session, and then they have to follow strict rules, which is, like, obviously no biting, no
cool.
It's like the beginning of the UFC. Listen, you can't poke eyes out, no punching the balls, but everything else is cool.
Pretty much. So
I'm for this because that's where my kid would be, like, in that zone. Like, he's not.
And he's gonna be the king of it.
I don't know if he'll be the king.
I can't bite, but I can break your arm.
So I'm glad they have it. That's cool.
Some people on the opposite end, they're just saying, like, well, I don't know.
The snowflakes.
Yeah, they're just like, well, you know, this might cause peer pressure.
Shut the fuck
bullying.
Up.
And now you're just, like, enabling bullying in this particular area.
Dude, do you know what causes bullying? It's just people hanging out with each other. Like, what are you talking about? Like, for me, bullying was just, like, when I was a kid, getting bullied or bullying someone else was just about correcting behavior. It was like, some kids has a rolly backpack. Okay, we need to kick this kid's ass. Mm-hmm. He's not better than that. it's not about, like,
that's fucked up.
But no, then there's the shit where it's like, well, he's a gay kid, fuck the gay kid or whatever, and that shit stuff.
Yeah.
But the societal correction shit, I think, is dope. And I enjoy it. like, for example, there was a kid who used to walk along the perimeter of our school alone, and we were always like, you better stay over there alone.
Yeah.
You know, to make sure that he
there
was constantly
alone. There
was
this one kid in elementary school that always was squeezing his balls with his hand in his pocket, and we always made fun of him, and he stopped doing it.
Right.
Because, I mean, that's just weird.
Yeah.
He's in the playground, and he has his hand in his pocket, and he's squeezing the shit out of his balls like this, and then everyone's like, why do you have your hand in your pocket? And you're playing with yourself. And you make fun of him, and then he won't do it anymore.
He did it when he left.
Probably, but it's inappropriate in front of people. Is
alone.
What we're, you know? Yeah, it's like...
Like a normal human being.
Yeah.
You squeeze your balls at home.
Yeah.
It's like shitting your pants. You don't want to shit your pants at school because everyone's going to make fun of you.
Yeah.
And then you're like, oh, I probably shouldn't shit my pants.
I know, I wonder what the case is now with people not making fun of other people. Like, what, they're just like, yeah, I think I should shit my pants. Like, there's no repercussions to that.
Thank you, Tiffy.
Are people like, it's okay, we all shit our pants from time to time.
That's what's gonna happen. Everyone's gonna walk around with poopy butt now because of this shit.
I think that's what the teachers do, right? They're like, okay, little Anderson shit his pants again. Let's all take a moment of silence and prayer. I think everyone just sits there and they're like getting positively reinforced for shitting in their pants.
They do a circle and everyone's holding hands with each other and they're like, it's like everyone tell you their shit their pants story so we can normalize this behavior. And I'm like,
yeah.
All right. I wonder if the common knowledge in psychology has shifted, because when I was taking like child development and shit like that, they were saying boys tend to test their limits and learn, right, like what is safe, what isn't safe, their boundaries with other boys, things like that, by roughhousing, by doing risky play. And that was helping them develop into becoming men.
Well, it's interesting you bring that up, because that is one of the reasons why they brought this back in a designated area, because of all those reasons, right, you just said. Because
if they don't, you know, engage in risky behavior, they never learn consequence, they never learn a lot of other things.
Because, yeah,
like, I think guys just inherently are risky and they do stupid shit because we don't think things through and we think we'll be okay.
That's cute, because we'll just sounds like guys are dumb.
You know what?
We are in a lot of ways.
I know what the line is, but if I can't punch someone.
It's the dumbness that pushes the boundaries and changes the world.
Thank you, my man. I want that on a shirt. And, oh, real quick though, Gio, just to challenge, because you said that all guys are dumb or whatever, right?
Yeah.
I got a story for you.
Okay, let's
hear it. So once I learned, once me and my group of guys, circle friends, once we learned that we could flex our abs and make them really hard, we started punching each other in the stomach. And we were all like in a circle punching each other in the stomach and flexing our abs. Now, is that dumb?
No, dude, that's not dumb at all.
There you go. Thank you. Awesome. Thank you. That's big of you. Thank you.
It's funny that they have this, because my kids, I remember when I was in school, we fought all the time. We roughhousing in school was just playing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then we actually fought. Like, mm-hmm, we got in fights all the time.
Yeah.
And my kids do not get in fights. So I'm like worried that
it's a different world.
Yeah, they'll get socked up right now. Yeah. Two kids.
Well, you're doing better now and you're out of where you grew up, and because that's
no. Like in our neighborhood, it's pretty cool, like chill. But if there's like a kid who's like, look, I'm not playing by none of these rules, he would dominate the playground because nobody fights anymore. Nobody even like protects anymore.
Really?
Oh my gosh. Like, the teacher's always there. I feel like when we were kids, the teachers didn't care if you were getting socked up. Like, unless you were bleeding.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah,
whatever, man. That's kids being kids, boys being boys.
Yeah, I remember like growing up, like even junior high or high school, or even like the tail end of elementary school, like being down was pretty important.
Yeah.
So like, you had that homie that always got fucked up.
Right.
Like, he was just the worst fighter, but he was still down to throw down, you know? Yeah. So you're like,
that's how you get respect.
Yeah, so he still gets respect, and then, you know, if shit happens, like, he wouldn't rat out on you, and you kind of had like this tight group thing. But now I feel like if something happens, like, they would just all rat on each other, because there's that loyalty or that bond. They're not really down for each other.
That's the whole issue about the toxic masculinity or whatever they call it. Mm-hmm. It's like it creates PTSD in boys, and then they grow up like just like doggy dog kind of. That's one of the arguments, I think.
Oh.
I mean it's abnormal, right? Like, it's because we just only grew up in an area that's more violent. So, mm-hmm. But I think this is the other side where it's too safe, where it's unrealistic, and they grew up in these bubbles.
Yeah.
And then they get into the real world and they get fucked up.
Do your kids play sports?
My youngest plays sports. My oldest is like into stop motion and creating and stuff.
Yeah, that's tight.
Totally different.
So one's like an artist and one's more of an athlete.
One athlete, and the younger one, like, my older son loves every movie. My younger son is like, if there's no fighting in it, it's just like, is it even a movie?
Does your younger son punk the older son?
Yeah. But the thing is, my older son ain't no punk. Like, he'll let him live, and then, I'm sorry, and then once he checks him, then my younger son's like, wow, so this is how you treat me? All I've been doing is annoying you for 8 hours, and you really want to push me? Your brother,
it's like the chihuahua and the pit bull.
Exactly.
It's like the relaxed pit bull and a baby chihuahua.
Yeah, but in like my youngest son plays soccer, and he like they are like soccer is way more physical than I realized.
Yeah.
Because I didn't play soccer growing up.
Pushing and all that.
Pushing and violence and stuff, and he loves it.
Mm.
They push each other down, so I feel like they have that in sports. But if your kid doesn't play sports, then
that's true. There's no outlet.
Kid might not touch you like ever.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, when I was a kid, we were just physical. Tag was tag, but you would like, boom, like you're it. Like, why are you hitting me with two hands? You just have to touch my shirt.
And then kids will get their feelings hurt because they lost, and it'll turn into a fight.
Yeah.
Dude, we would do basement fights where we're all just fighting each other, and then if there was girls there, we really wanted to fight each other, which I don't know why, because it's like two guys fucking fighting each other, and then we look at the girl like, do you
they did that for me in the sandbox. I was like, oh, they're fighting for me.
You're the psycho, because most girls, they just walk away. They're like,
these kids I was in elementary.
These boys are dumb.
But did it impress you? It's
like, well, yeah, because two guys wanted me, so I'm like, okay.
So it does work.
It does work.
only her types, though.
In elementary.
Only her type.
That's amazing.
In elementary.
You were making it clear that you were fighting for the girl, because for you, if there were just two guys just fighting randomly, you wouldn't care. It was just the fact that they were fighting for you.
In elementary, I don't know, dude. Like, I probably liked gummy. I don't know. I don't know what the fuck was going on.
I think it's just attention, right? They're trying to get some attention.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because you can tell the two boys are like,
yeah. Oh, hell yeah.
They're looking this way at the chick.
We did it anyway, but when a chick was there, we went hard.
Yep, yeah. Even harder.
Because you want to look manly.
Yeah.
That's good.
Okay, let me ask you this. So as a father, I've always wanted to know this, because it's like raising a kid now. It's like, if your son comes home and he's like, I'm getting bullied, what do you say?
It's interesting. That happened. My youngest son was like, yo, this kid was hitting me, punching me, and he's like super strong. Like, my youngest son is ridiculously strong, country strong. So I was like, here's what you do. You tell your teacher, because I don't want him to go outside of the rules. Tell the teacher, you give your teacher an opportunity to stop it. Yeah. Tell the teacher and they don't stop it, then you punch that kid in the face as hard.
Hell yeah.
And then I'll deal with the teacher. And the teacher came and was like, hey, did you tell him this? I was like, I absolutely told him that if y'all don't stop it, because the teachers ain't always gonna be there.
Yeah.
So if y'all ain't gonna protect him, then he gonna have to socks. And I said, punch him right in the nose. To the back of his head.
Yeah. Go through.
Through his, I'm talking about hips, turn into it.
Yeah.
Like I showed them, both of them. Punch him in the face and
printed the kid's face.
Yes.
Yes. From the yearbook.
You're like, break your hand on his face.
And I said, I'll take you to the movies. You won't get in trouble at home. You get suspended, we'll go see Avengers. I got you.
Oh, that's so dope.
So good.
You have to give the teachers an opportunity. And they did.
That's a good balance.
Yeah.
And then the narking, I like that. But you did teach him to narc, though.
Well, because you'll get in trouble if he fights back without telling the teacher, then he gets in trouble.
I won't forget that.
Well, that's smart.
That's strategy, Steve. That's strategy.
Now it's on the school.
I won't roll.
Because it's like, I gave you an opportunity, but he kept doing it, and you didn't stop it.
Yeah.
That's smart.
And so now it's 1-1.
What ended up happening?
That's dope. I like that.
So really interesting thing happened. The teacher stopped it, and they made the kid write us a note. Like, he had to write my son a note and the parent. So the note was literally like, I kid you not, dear Mr. and Mrs. Josiah's dad, I'm sorry for punching your kid. And I was like, that was the first line of the note. Oh, he's really a nice kid. We were just playing. He should have said something. Like, and that's what he said. He was like, so we're actually just really playing, and he didn't even say stop.
Oh.
And I had to tell my son, like, yo, if y'all are playing, like, don't make me look dumb. So if y'all are playing,
you fuck me over.
And he don't know that it's a problem, then say something.
Yeah.
But if he's bullying you, then stop.
Your son after, like, you made me look dumb.
And I was like, cuz, you got to write the letter to me, man. Now I feel weak. Now I got to fight his dad. Where's your dad at? I got a sock him to make it even.
It's complicated.
Well, two, plus, if your son wasn't, if they were just playing around, and then your kid tells the teacher nothing really happens and they're playing around again, your son's going to punch a kid in the fucking nose.
I know.
And now I got to do, now he's confused. It's confusing lyrics. Yeah. It's confusing instructions.
That's true, because the first thing he should have said is, hey, I don't like that.
Exactly.
Then he would have been like, oh, sorry.
And I told him, you got to give people a chance, because sometimes people don't know unless you tell them. So it was a whole, that's the thing about parenting, like, that's scary. Like, you really have responsibility to these kids' lives. I don't know what I'm doing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Nobody gave me a test. They just handed this kid to me. Like, I took more tests before I worked at Burger King. And all I had to do was put meat in the back of a thing. I gotta create a whole person's vision of the world. I don't need the responsibility. I just wouldn't have sex.
Very true.
I like that.